My name is Mark Lanzieri. I'm an interventional cardiologist and my practice is in Central Maine. I graduated from SGU in 1985 and I've been involved in a visiting cardiology program since 2001. When the clinic started, we were doing outpatient consultative cardiology like we would in any cardiology office, and we were performing echocardiography. Since that time, the program has grown to include pacemaker implantation and most recently coronary angiography. That happened because all the pieces were in the right place at the right time, from the administration to the general hospital to U.S. industry support, and I think I was wise enough to recognize the pieces were ready to be put together. So 18 months ago, we floated the idea to the university, and finally, last week, we performed the first procedures with the new equipment. The new equipment was scheduled to arrive shortly before our arrival. It arrived the Friday before our week. It eventually got to the hospital at 1 in the afternoon on Thursday. The first case was performed at 3:30 that same afternoon. I come back because as time goes on, I feel that I have been given an awful lot of opportunity and an awful lot of nice things have happened to me. We went to school a long time and we had to work very hard, but at the end of the day, some of it was just luck that we were where we were. We could just have easily been born somewhere else rather than the United States. So when we come back, I think that we come back because we feel obliged to give back to someone, and in this case, it's Grenadians. The connection to the people that I see is very much the connection to my patients in my home practice. People are people, and I think if you're sincere in wanting to deliver care or wanting to take care of an individual, even in the circumstances where in Grenada we didn't have the means to do that, I think people feel that connection. And we know a lot of friends in Grenada now when we come back and we see them in follow-up in the clinic or we run into them at food fair. There was limited cardiac care before 2001. To give us the example of pacemaker implantation, pacemakers were implanted in 1959. And in 2001, the first one was implanted here. So this is a large gap of delivery of technology. And it's not just the delivery of technology, but the delivery of personnel who are skilled in that technology. As our team has gotten bigger, it's required more coordination to have as many people get out of their practices as possible. So we try to be always a trip ahead. The current team for this trip was larger than trips past. The initial team was Annie alone, who is my radiation technologist, who came from the very first time we started coming. The second member of the team is Lee, who is our representative from Medtronic Corporation, who has donated approximately $250,000 in equipment in the last 12 years. Lee is our person who is most familiar with the pacemaker function. New to the team this time were Sean, who was a nurse anesthetist from my own hospital, and Lori, who's a critical care flight nurse. These two pieces were integral to perform the kind of procedures that we're doing now. It's extremely rewarding to be involved in something from start to finish, and I think too many people have an idea or a vision, but unless there's execution from a variety of viewpoints, it's just an idea.
Leaving our mark for posterity. We came, we saw, we dilated.
Right here.
We're okay.
My left-handedness, I'll do it first so I don't leave a smudge mark.
Similar.
Where do I sign?
Right under Lori. Yeah, you sign just like mine.
I'm trying to make it just so late as 15 to be made, but I think it's still up here.